Really?
Yeah, under the
All
duvet.
All right, Stevie, absolutely. Thank you very much. Yeah, give it up for Steve Trullier, everybody.
I could run circles around any special agent. Just call me 00 Willis. After the break, we'll be revealing this week's Save and Replace task. But if you want to know now, go to the homepage now! Oi, get up. Star jumps. Now. Star jumps. You look like a fish. You're not doing too badly, though, so carry on. See you in five. Welcome back to Little Brother. The time is almost 6:17.
Indeed, it is. Still to come, we'll be discussing House Heartthrobs with former BB stud Maxwell.
But first, Agent Lamb!
Yeah?
Get in the gallery and do the news!
Emily, you're supposed to be doing the news today, babe.
Do you want to live?
Yes.
Then get in the gallery and do the news now.
Have you taken your medication?
No! Get in the gallery and do the news now!
Right, at 2:53 yesterday afternoon, John James made a bid for freedom by breaking through the fire escape. If you didn't see last night's BBLB, basically, he upset Josie by comparing the relationship to Shabby and Kiva. Then he got upset, she was upset, and tried to leave. This is what happened when he met Big Brother producers in the camera runs.
I love her in that. I just don't want to hurt anyone. I could come across as, like, leading someone on or making someone look stupid or, like, embarrassing someone, and that's not what I want to do.
Yeah, of course not.
Take a deep breath, walk past everybody, and then if you want, you know, just talk to Big Brother, yeah?
Yeah.
Hey! He's back!
You knew they hadn't got the awards at the end of the show. Yours could be, like, the biggest crier award.
Yeah.
The biggest crier award goes to John James!
We're glad he chose to stand a bit longer, and later on in the news you will find out why. Now, it's only her fourth day in, and the pressure of the Big Brother house has already got to Laura. Surely not. Could she be our third walker?
I just want to go home now. I just feel like I'm not being myself. I feel nervous all the time. It's just too much. I just can't deal with it.
I think you've got to give it a chance.
Give it a
you've only been here, you've had one full day. What's your
wish? I've already said and they've already done it. Yeah.
Give it till Friday. Experience, yeah. Experience the task.
Yeah, do a task.
Wait for somebody to go on Friday. And if you feel like that, just do it for the week. So at least you've had 1 week in the Big Brother house.
Yeah. Will she stay or will she go? Watch this space, everybody. Now, the Josie John James drama didn't end with his attempted escape. Late last night, the pair got cosy under the covers, and it seemed their relationship has finally taken a step forward only 8 weeks later.
Come here.
Shut up.
Josie,
stop.
Whatever, just stop.
What then?
It's like...
What? Just joking or
what? It's like a long kiss.
What, like now?
Yeah.
He's too embarrassed to open his mouth then. I think it's why I should have that. Never happened, she'll have to go off.
Ethan, I told you what I was like with girls.
So he doesn't fancy her, but he does want to sleep in the bed with her. He did kiss her and he wants to see what happens on the outside. I'm pretty confused. But don't worry, psychologist Pam Spurt will be here tomorrow to get to the bottom of it. And at 1:32 this afternoon, the housemates gathered around to discover this week's nominations.
Yes. The housemates nominated for eviction this week, in no particular order, are
a few.
Steve.
Ooh.
Steve. We must be all out there.
And
all
the Ben. And Dave.
There's a surprise. I knew I was up.
And John James.
Stick around to find out the Save and Replace task. Stick around to find out how the Save and Replace task turned out. Remember, you can get everything as soon as it happens on the World Wide Web by typing this code into your computer.
Back in 2005, my next guest spent a dramatic 43 days in the house. He counted maggots in a task dressed as a baby and fell in love with a saucy lady. It's BB6's Maxwell. How are you?
Good for you.
It's nice to have you here for 5 minutes rather than 5 seconds like you did on Sunday when you just jumped out of the box and said hello.
Rubbish. Getting paid by the word, I think, on Sunday, weren't
I? But at least you're here for a bit more substantial time now. Right, OK, so during your time in the house, there was quite a lot of naughtiness that went on, especially with you and Saskia.
Oh, no, yeah.
So there's one little...
Saskia's coming to watch.
So are you guys still in touch? You went out for quite a while, didn't you?
Yeah, I was with her for about... officially about a year, living together for about 16 months.
Yeah.
That was a nightmare.
So you're still in touch now?
Not since I locked her in the attic, no.
You've never been allowed out. So we thought that we'd get your take on romances in the Big Brother house, seeing as you're kind of seasoned.
Been there, done it.
Yeah, you've been there, done it. Now, there seems to be something of a love triangle emerging in the house, and strangely enough, it's Ben who has turned into the heartbreaker.
I know, he's right in the middle of it.
Before we talk about him, let's have a look at him in action.
I couldn't imagine you as a boyfriend.
Probably wouldn't be a very good one.
No.
Same thing what you said to me, you said to another girl.
What did I say?
I love that girl, Laura.
I adore Rachel.
I really love you so much, I really like you.
I've always thought he was a bit of a womanizer.
You sliming all over Laura hasn't gone unnoticed by everybody.
You flirt with most people, babe. How many girlfriends have you got?
It's quite difficult because they're generally other people's girlfriends.
Right.
So didn't realise you were upset.
Yeah, why didn't you realise? Because you was too busy being Mr. Tickle.
You were on her like a cheap suit.
Don't find yourself leading people up the garden path.
It's not until you watch something like that that you realise how much
I didn't realise. He's a bit of a stud, isn't he? I only had one. He's got half a dozen chasing around him.
I know.
Boys and girls. What's all that about?
I know.
I had Craig run me
feet. Do you feel hard done by?
I do a little bit, yeah. Going, oh, do you think you're a seasoned pro? I've got to add one. And I was chasing after her.
Never mind. You got her in the end.
Yeah.
And then knocked her in the attic, so it's fine.
That's it, yeah. Exactly.
So is he a harmless flirt or is he a womaniser in disguise? A heartbreaker, rather than
he's not your typical Premier League footballer, is he? Do you know what I mean?
But
he's obviously has a way with the ladies. And
yeah.
So you never know. He's getting to know them all, isn't he? They're coming in different times, so he's spending a bit of time with one, moving on to the other. He's having a good time in there.
Do you think that might be part of his plan, though, to get the whole house to like him?
Well, maybe.
He's always very worried about the people that have an argument with him.
Well, they're all going after him and moaning about him, trying to flirt with him. So if I was him, I'd probably be doing the same. I think you should leave him alone a little bit.
So is he worthy of that heartbreaker tag, do you think?
Oh, we'll see how many hearts he breaks, I suppose, and then he might be by the end of it.
Well, he's already broken Rachel's by the looks of it. She was really upset.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, yeah, I know what you mean. She's still having a moan at him and that, but I'm sure if he turned the tables after he's up for eviction this week, you could turn it back and give her a cuddle.
Right, I was going to get on to whether he could turn it back, actually. Last night, Rachel questioned Ben's sexuality. So is a Shirley Bassey, hair-obsessed man your classic womaniser? Because you're kind of seasoned in these things.
Well, until I see that, I thought I was. Well, I don't know, he's not a typical womaniser, but, you know, it takes all shapes and sizes, doesn't it?
It does, but he's kind of... I think it's kind of going against him now because you've got... It's backfiring a little bit because you've got Mario who's kind of turned against him and you've got Rachel who's turned against him and they've both nominated him this week.
Well, that's because he's dogged them both on, hasn't he?
Do you think he will claw it back?
Well, the thing is...
Is he going to turn on that usual charm?
Well, he could do, but the reason he's left him in the lurch, so they've obviously got the ump, so they put him up for eviction. So, you know, he could all turn it around as soon as if he stays in on Friday night.
Is he getting what he deserves?
Probably a little bit, yeah.
Do you think he'll go on Friday?
I'd like to think not, because obviously there's all this going on about him. I think he'll stay.
Yeah. Okay. Right, very quickly, we've got to talk about John James and Josie, because that's another romance going on. Yesterday, John James obviously walked out of the house and Josie said that they shared their first kiss.
Wow.
So what's it like falling for someone in that kind of environment? Because you've done it.
Falling for someone, it's like a pressure cooker in there. If you're there 6 days, it's like more like 6 weeks, you know, and 60 days more like 6 months. So you're always together.
Yeah.
And I think that from the start, you could tell they liked each other.
Yeah.
And then, I don't know, he ran out last night after she kissed him or something, so she can't be that good.
But what about, in your experience, getting intimate with someone? That's got to be hard doing it in there.
The thing is, you don't realise the cameras around you. You don't realise the cameras around you, so it's like...
You forget.
You forget, obviously.
Cameras.
Yeah, and noises and chucking off the sheets and that. It's just...
OK, I think we should stop now.
Yeah.
Maxwell, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Feel free to jog on.
Yeah, I will do, yeah.
Why, Maxwell? Get down and give me 20 press-ups! Don't just look at me! Get down and give me 20 press-ups! 30 press-ups! Boy, the man cheeky! Carry on! Don't stop!
Look at these guns!
Do you want to know which weakling won the save and replace?